What up? This is Swayze, and I'm gonna make this a quick video because who would have known that Asian Daw is so talented? First, she's a rapper, and she's not that bad if you ask me. Second, she only dates killers, which means she's a strong black queen. And third, Asian Daw can actually communicate with the dead? Now, if you're not aware, Asian Daw went on Twitter and revealed King Von's last words. And they were, "Y'all let them niggas get up on me. Stop crying. Y'all let them get me." And she continues to say, "Y'all left my boy when he was unarmed, and he would have hawked MFers down for them and spent again, again, and again. It's crazy. I knew my boy heart and loyalty wasn't deserved. He's okay though." So after I seen these tweets, right, I was like, yo, hold up. King Von was texting Asian Daw while he was bleeding out and dying? That has to be one of the most savagest things I've ever heard in my life. You telling me while he's coughing out blood, he took out his iPhone, unlocked it, went to his messages, and told Asian Daw, yo, these people did not protect me and they let me get shot? But we quickly found out that's not the case, because DJ Academics had an interview with King Von's manager. And he said this.
Tweeted some of the stuff and I reached out to her. I'm like, hey, bro, I know you're mourning and you hurt like everybody else, but you need to slow down because one, you wasn't there. So how can you make assumption and accuse guys of doing this and that? And the last words that she's talking about, and it's in a text message and I can show you, she's talking to Von through her spiritual advisor from after death.
What?
Wait. So this is what she tweeted. She tweeted, "Von's last word was, y'all let them niggas get up on me. Stop crying. Y'all let them get me." As if Von was talking to his homie saying.
Hold on, Ak. I'm gonna show you right now. Her text message, clearly.
Yeah.
Oh, I talked to Von on a spiritual level.
What?
With a spirit reader, and he's letting shit be known.
Oh,
he's
nah.
Talking for sure. And he feel y'all shouldn't let him get it. Facts. So you talking to the dead now, Asian Daw. So Von on the afterlife.
Yo, what's really going on right now? You telling me Asian Daw out here talking to the dead through her spiritual advisors? She bogged out. See, I understand there are some people who believe that their family members and loved ones can contact them after they pass. However, when it comes to Asian Daw, if you do believe King Von told you this from the afterlife, why would you get on Twitter and tell everybody else? He literally just got killed. Nobody really understands what's going on. And you're gonna vaguely put on Twitter that his last words were his boys didn't hold him down when he needed them the most? I mean, how inconsiderate can you be? You know niggas gonna pull up to their Instagram and blame them for King Von's death. And at the end of the day, Asian Daw did this for attention. If she's really in contact with King Von's spirit right now, why don't she just drop the interview and let him say it with his own words on a Ouija board or something? Why are you over here giving us cryptic messages and shit that we gotta decode? At this point, I'm starting to think Asian Daw just lied altogether. She ain't in contact with King Von. Like, come on. First you telling everybody that you only want to date killers, and now you trying to tell me that you're the only one that could get in contact with these killers after they die? If you ask me, Asian Daw should look into doing some police work at this point. Shorty know all the killers, dated all the killers, and she could get in contact with the dead to find out who killed them. But all jokes aside, this is why I always say, niggas need to be careful with who they messing with while they're alive. I'm telling you. Same thing happened to Pop Smoke. When he died, it was like 78 bitches that came out of nowhere claiming that they was the Big Wu's one and only true love. And I just thought it was disgusting. You had females posting up pics from 4 years ago, 5 years ago, claiming they was his girlfriend. And I was like, come on, bruh. Stop trying to play my nigga Pop out like that. Now that he dead, y'all wanna act like he was running around putting promise rings on every dot finger. That's not the case. He told you, if he call you bae, then you bae for the day. or your bae for the night, but you're not his wife. Why would you, now that he's dead, try to claim wifey status? You see what they doing out here, B? Pop Smoke is from Brooklyn for real. He don't gotta lie to no thot and tell her, yo, yeah, you my girlfriend, just so he could hit. I never had to tell a chick, yo, you my girlfriend, to get some buns. And I'm nobody. And you telling me Pop Smoke made all of you chicks his girlfriend? I'm not falling for the fugaziness. And now look at Asian Dar coming out of nowhere. Yeah, y'all, I just spoke to Vaughn. He said he's still smoking on Tuca. He said he saw FBG Duck and all the dead ops and they wasn't on shit. Like, this is the nonsense we gotta look forward to now. Asian Dar, the ghost whisperer. But pull up in the comment section and let me know how you feel about this situation. And if you like the video, don't forget to share, subscribe to the channel if you're not already, and make sure you hit that notification button. But I'm off this.
Demon time. Demon time after nine, she's a vibe, yeah, demon time, yeah, ass get to shaking, 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 and her back get to breaking, yeah, demon time, demon time, demon time, I killed the pussy, but she's alive, yeah, it's demon time, she's reading minds, I see the lies, it's in her eyes.